concussion, where are we? I think Mr. Collins is going to come in next week. But if you guys, I know I asked you guys to make a list of anything that we need. How would we come again?
The only thing that we don't have is the three coffee cans and egg shakers.
Well, we have it.
Okay.
So we will defer to the awesome. Does anyone have, like, with coffee grounds, they have, like, the metal. Unfortunately, now they start using plastic.
It's hard to find now.
If anyone has metal coffee cans or, or, like, big metal containers. I mean, it's coal grass, so the bigger metal container, the better. Just not a trash can. That's too big. There's another piece that he's written in there. So big metal containers, we need a couple of them. So, the Barry Sachs is not counted as a big metal container. So if anybody who has something that we could use, bring that on Monday, and then we will try out different sounds. Yeah, that one. I'm just kidding. Wednesday. You have to be a drum major. So bring it Wednesday, and I'll send out something to you as you learn, just so it's not forgotten. Cool. This is measure 76. Question for Brass. It's been difficult the past. It's been difficult the past couple of rehearsals when we switch from the four to the big two pattern. Is it easier for you if I just stay in four for a couple measures and then maybe move into the two just to make sure we can solidify tempo? Yes? Okay, cool. Awesome. So we're at 76. Someone in the brass section who has a primary voice in this is really easy. Trumpet. Yes. So, Kelsey. And what is your name?
Austin.
Kelsey and Austin have the primary part. So, can you picture, just close your eyes right now, brass players, picture that your sound is going to come out of their bells. That's how I want you to play. Put your sound into their sound. Cool? Same place. Make that adjustment. It worked. So even more. That was 50%, go 125. Trumpets, you're playing footballs. That's what your sound looks like right now. Play bricks. Da 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 dee da da dee. Don't da 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 da. We don't want any of that. It should be all bricks. Solid. It should look like a wall. If we didn't have the curtain up, you turn around and look at the brick wall. That's what should be what the notes look like. Okay? Same place. Are we ready to brace for a moment? Not all subdividing together. So we have, that's the reason why we're going from the four into the two, just so you can get the subdivisions better. Can we have brass and whoever's playing start at 76 and go on your own and subdivide on your own without you know. So always think about keeping the bow moving, because the moment you stop the bow, the sound stops. Okay? So this is, I like it so much, let's start 76. It sounds great. It'll make it even better. Think of something you can make. More confident with your entrances, it's really hard. hard. I can't do this. That won't work. And that just looks stupid. So be confident with your entrances. That really counts on you subdividing internally. Can we just have the first flutes play their entrance at 80? One, two, three. Okay, so everyone heard that tone, right? You heard that the intensity of the sound, and it's great. So every single sound that comes after that needs to fit into that. Needs to be as confident as that and have the same tonal energy as that. Cool? Awesome. Everyone. Tutti. Hey. Let's start before that and we'll add the brass in. 76. Tenor saxophone at 97, and that's the correct mark. Correct. Slur the first three eighth notes, and it's yeah. And we're gonna change that because it doesn't match what the original intent is. Yes. Yes. Let's go right on measure 88. much better and match when you have the match what the first presentation of that voice or that motive gives you. So exactly what the first one is. Let's go at 88 again. Even more with the stirring from the crescendo brass. It was quite nice with that time of exaggerating. I have an idea, and let's see what you think about this. What if we were to start our decrescendo on the downbeat of 88 class? How do you think about it? Let's hear it. 88. And there's an aspect of this, the lessons that he took, that all of his music is programmatic, and he's painting a picture with it. So you'll notice in there the children's orchestra, the adult orchestra, and the machine. And so when we get to this point, up to this point, you have two divided orchestras, right? You have the brass as the adult orchestra, and the woodwinds as the children's orchestra. And at this point, this is when he brings the ensemble together, and what he's doing is he develops the children's orchestra to get them, as they grow older, to be more mature players. So he gets to here, and he's developed the children's orchestra to get to the level of the adult orchestra, and this is when the entire ensemble is able to play this melody together as one ensemble. Pretty cool. And so at this point, this is when we need to be moving together, like the brass developed this in the last couple days, and into this great sounding brass section. We need to put our sounds into that entire ensemble sound. Cool. So Much better. Do more with those decrescendos before we get to that point. So that's before 103. Any of you who have that, the mezzo forte to piano. If we need to start a little bit louder and bring it down even a little bit quieter, that would be great. Let's go at 88 and get into that again. And then just think about that. We need one sound when we get to that. When we get to the melding of the two parts. Did the brass play their decrescendo there as well? Was it better than they've done it in the past? Worse or the same? Worse. Okay? Same place. Change it. Fix it.
Thank you.
That will always be our standard from now on. Don't play any worse than that, except for the kind of weird choices of key over here in the clarinets for a little bit. But that should be the standard. Hold yourself and the people around you to. I'm trying to give you a compliment in your talking. That's just rude. Always hold each other to that standard. Don't go any lower than that. Y'all can be just as good as Wind Ensemble and play just as well. Just work that much harder. Cool? Kelsey.
In measure 120, the on beat 3 and 4, that beat, the collection
was something sound. You said 120, 120. Talking the concert B flat and the concert A. It's a cluster. It's basically a cluster, kind of a cluster chord. I shouldn't say a cluster chord. It's more. I mean, I had to really diagnose it without. But it's more of a passing tone, and it highlights a 13th.
Okay.
So, cool. Thank you for all of your hard work. Yes. For this entire section, it's more of this. This is supposed to sound a little weird. There were some notes in not including that it was a little funky, because what happens is he's trying to get us, he's moving it all back into.
That's right.
Yeah, that's correct. Cool. Thank you for all of your hard work. We'll see you on Wednesday. I won't be here Monday.